All right. Good afternoon, everybody. So I thought today we could do some more experimenting on the head turner puppet. I'd like to try motion library on her. I've never tried motion library on head turner, and then keep in mind too, it's head turner with back hair. So I don't know if motion library, I think it can detect two heads. So all I did was export the puppet and let's re-import it under the new name. So we'll import Head Turner Motion Library and let's get to work. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna wanna do is add body behavior and add motion library behavior. And I'll just leave all the draggers and everything as is until we see how everything works, and maybe we might want to take them off if we want to try some animation later. Okay, so frontal, I don't want tagged as a head anymore. And then head, let's go down to head. I don't want independent anymore. And then I'm going to do the same to back hair, make it not independent anymore. Then I'm going to go to the body layer and I'll add a waist tag to that. And then I think that's all I do with a normal puppet. Let's pull it in and see how we did. Okay, so head turner is still working. Let's zoom in a little bit. And let's turn motion library on. Let's just do a simple one, beat step. Okay, so we've got a problem with the hair. Okay, so I think if we go into back hair, let's make this not a head and make those a head. Let's see how that works. Okay, so we're not getting proper head rotation, but I think now they're not attached properly anymore. So if we go in and put those where we want them to pivot, will that make a difference? I think head turner would work fine as long as you didn't have back hair. Like, I don't think you'd have to do all these extra settings because I think it's detecting the front head fine. I think it's just making sure that it knows that there's more than one head. Okay, still not. That's pretty good, actually. It's still sticking out a little in the back. Let's turn motion library off for a second. Okay, I wonder if that's because we have the back hair rigged like an ear. Do we still have it rigged like an ear? No. Do we have these rigged like an ear? Yes, we do. So if we rig those like a head instead, 0, 0, 75. Would that work? Okay, so that fixed it up without motion library. Let's turn motion library back on. That's pretty good. It's not exactly on. There's a little bit of, I wonder if we go into motion library and uncheck. Rotation. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. The ponytail seems to move a little more than the rest of the head. But I think it's maybe because I don't have my pivot points in exactly right. Let's try a few different dances just in case. Ooh, Bella dance. Yeah, that works pretty good. I wasn't certain it would be possible to do all that. But everything seems to work good. Like the dangles still work good on all the levels. I'll have to go back and take some notes because the extra. So what did we do on the back hair? We made it not a head anymore. We made the actual heads heads. And then we took parallax off it. I think that's all that we did. But she looks great, huh? As usual, I just love Motion Library. Oh, are we getting a little... Yeah, maybe it's not exactly perfect. I think I'd have to go in and adjust the pivot points a little bit to get it exactly perfect, but I'm pretty happy with that. I wonder, do we want to try recording? So I don't know if you'd want to do the head take live or not. You get a lot of, you have to turn on and off a lot of stuff. So let's turn everything off except Motion Library. And do one recording. Let's actually just make a treadmill. And we'll close tracked handles. We'll record one motion. And then I guess if you wanted to do a head take, whew, you'd turn everything back on and then turn off everything that you were done. So you'd probably be done triggers. You'd probably be done, well, you wouldn't be using draggers because you'd have Motion Library, so we'll turn all the draggers off. Then Motion Library would be done, Lip Sync would be done, Eye Gaze would be done. And then if you went back in here, and refreshed, look at your timeline with head turner. Okay, let's see how that played though. I'm kind of interested. So let's turn everything off, and then because we have Motion Library, we'll go back to the beginning and refresh, and then hit play. Yay, that worked! Awesome! Yeah, Motion Library is so cool. And if you can have head turner and everything, I mean, if you wanted to do editing after, it'd be kind of a bear. I wonder if there is a cleaner way. Let's just delete all that stuff off the timeline because we know that works. If we wanted to do head turner as a swap set, so you'd pull in head and create swap set, and then you'd have to add your back hair in, I think, right? Okay, and then let's put left quarter as M. So now if I turn everything on and hit M, yeah, she turns. So you could then, let's turn everything off and get that on our timeline by turning on just triggers. We'll hit M and hit Control 2 and pull that out. So now we'd be able to make her turn her head. Let's go right quarter Create profile. Oops. Let's actually pull this out so we can see frame by frame. And then write profile. And then write quarter again. And let's go straight to upward. Those are on long enough for us to actually see them. Okay, let's try that. Yeah, that works totally. Okay, well, that it was mildly complicated, I guess, doing the switchover. But I think it works good. You'd have to be careful about your pivot points anyway, but yeah, another successful test, I guess, for Motion Library. Boy, those little pivot points up at the top corner are kind of bugging me. But it looks great. Anyway, I hope you have a great afternoon, everybody. Take care. Thanks for joining me. Bye. Here is a closer look at Head Turner with Motion Library. I still don't have my stuff lined up totally perfect, but it looks really good. I think it does a great job. So Head Turner, Motion Library, and back hair. Anyway, have a great afternoon, everybody. Take care. Bye.